بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، فاغفر لنا وارحمنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Dear brothers and sisters, in this weekly meeting every Sunday morning, we try to focus about what is important for this life and for the next life. We try to focus what we need to be the people who end at last in heaven, in paradise, in the Jannah of Allah. We try to do our best not to be of those people who will end in the hell. One important meeting and one important essential thing that Allah Azza wa Jal put us in this earth for main reason. This reason is education. Allah want us and give us all the means and all the ways to educate our soul, to educate our spirit, to elevate our mind, to elevate our morals, to changing us from human to believer. Human is just the raw material, the starting material. But to become believer in your morals, in your connection to Allah, in your love, in your high spirituality, this is the goal and this is the need from our existence in this earth. The first ayah in the Quran, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rabb, the Lord, the educator, who educate us. Educate us for what? For the happy life and for the next life. To be ready for the next life. And the curriculum and the subject and the material and the roadmap is the Quran. And in the first ayah, in the second surah in the Quran, Surah Al-Baqarah, Alif Lam Mim, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. This is the book. This is the book. This is the book you need. This is the subject. This is the data. This is the information you need for this life, to live a happy life, and for the next life to live endless of happiness and good life. For this reason, Allah Azza wa Jal sent the messengers. For this reason, Allah Azza wa Jal sent to us and tell us everything we need in this life. Everything everyone wants from, at least from a human, to be in the right position and to be in a good position. Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned in Surah Al-A'raf. In Surah Al-A'raf, ayah number 175. Surah Al-A'raf, the number of Surah Al-A'raf is number 7. Surah Al-A'raf number 7, ayah number 175. Allah give us an example and the good things in the Quran, that He give you the theoretical example, He give you the data, He give you the information, but after that He give you the real example. In Quran there is nothing imagination, nothing just not real. Everything in the Quran is about the reality, about how we should do, how we should follow, how we should did. This is the most important thing. For this reason, Allah Azza wa Jal give us a lot of example for everything. And this ayat is an example about how the Quran explained to us, how the Quran make it easy to everyone. وَاتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَأَ الَّذِي آتَيْنَاهُ آيَاتِنَا فَانْسَلَخَ مِنْهَا. Ayah number 175, Surah Al-A'raf. Recite to them the story of this person who we gave them the signs, but he turned away from it. He don't follow it. وَلَوْ شِئْنَا لَرَفَعْنَاهُ بِهَا. And if we will, and this is what we want. We want him to elevate by using this sign. وَلَوْ شِئْنَا لَرَفَعْنَاهُ بِهَا وَلَكِنَّهُ أَخْلَدَ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ. But he chose to going low and low and low. وَلَكِنَّهُ أَخْلَدَ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ وَاتَّبَعَ هَوَاهُ. And he followed his desire. فَمَثَلُهُ كَمَثَلْ كَلْبِ إِنْ تَحْمِلْ عَلَيْهِ يَلْهَثْ أَوْ تَتْرُكْهُ يَلْهَثْ. So this example is like the dog. If you put something over him, he's still making this painting, or you didn't, he's still doing the same. This is the situation of the dog. So this is the example of the people who refuse and who deny the signs of Allah. And at the end of the surah, Allah give us the wisdom. فَقْصُصِ الْقَصَصَ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُوا. So tell them the stories. Tell them the stories. Maybe they will think. Maybe they will understand. Tell them the story about the old nation. Tell them the story about the destiny of the people who reject the sign of Allah. Tell them the story about the nation who denied the prophet, who denied the message, who denied the book of Allah. Tell them about them. Their ruins is here and there. Their ruins everywhere. Their stories every place. So told them about this story. Told them about this nation, because it will be great lesson to them. It will be great way of understanding to them. فَقْصُصِ الْقَصَصَ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَذَكَّرُوا. Narrated the stories. Maybe they will remember. For this reason, and for this, we return to the stories of the prophets and messengers in the Quran. We return to their biography to understand the straight way, to understand the concept of the straight way, to understand the details of the straight way, to find if we are on the straight way or we are out of the straight way. Understand if we are on the straight way or we are out of the straight way. This is very, very important. We reach the story of the Prophet Salih. And as we said, Salih was a prophet to great nation. And Allah mentioned his name 9 times in the Quran. And Allah mentioned the story of his people, Thamud, about 20 times in 20 surah of the Quran. And this is give us very great example how this story is important, how this story full of wisdom, how we should avoid what happened to them, to avoid their destiny, because Allah destroyed them at the end. Allah Azza wa Jal narrated this story to Prophet Muhammad, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam understand. And Prophet Muhammad take the wisdom from this, and he do his best to avoid his nation from this destiny. He became patient. He don't want to punish them. He don't want. Furthermore, they do everything bad to him. They did everything bad to him. They tried to do anything to get rid of him, to kill him, to stop his calling, to stop his religion. But Rasulullah was patient, and Rasulullah understand the wisdom behind these stories. Yes, and now we receive this ayat. What is our position? If we understand, we will survive. If we follow, we will survive. If not, we will not. This is honesty. This is honesty. This is to be clear to everyone. So first of all, you are responsible about yourself. You are responsible to save yourself, to secure yourself. And then the people around you, your family, and then the bigger circle, that your friends, and then the people you know, and then how much you can spread this, how much you will save yourself and save the other and survive. As we said, we go to the story of Salih alayhi salam, and we start to get the wisdom. We start to get what is important to the straight way, because Allah said, Allah guided those to the straight way. And Allah said, so Allah guided those, so follow their guidance. Follow their guidance. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ هَدَى اللَّهُ فَبِهُدَاهُمُ اِقْتَدِي. And we reach what Allah Azza wa Jal said about Nabiullah Salih and his people in Surah Al-Shu'ara. Surah Al-Shu'ara is number 26. The number of Surah is 26. And Allah mentioned his prophet Salih and his people Thamud in Surah Al-Shu'ara from ayah number 141 to 159. And Allah Azza wa Jal start in Surah Al-Shu'ara, كَذَّبَتْ ثَمُودُ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. كَذَّبَتْ ثَمُودُ الْمُرْسَلِينَ, that the people of Thamud rejected the messengers, denied the messengers. How that? How Allah said that Thamud denied all the messengers, and they denied only Salih alayhi salam. They denied only Salih alayhi salam. What does that mean? That mean if you denied any prophet or messengers, it is like you denied all the prophet and messengers. This is the meaning. This is the meaning. And this is the meaning how Allah said, كَذَّبَتْ ثَمُودُ الْمُرْسَلِينَ, that Thamud, the people of Salih, they denied the messengers. It is the concept, because all these messengers sent by Allah Azza wa Jal to the human. So, O Allah, bear witness that we believe in you and believe in your Prophet Muhammad and believe in all prophets and messengers you send to the human, whose we know and who we doesn't know, who we didn't know. Who we didn't know. We believe in all of them. And this is what Allah mentioned at the end of Surah Al-Baqarah. آمَنَ الرَّسُولُ بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْهِ. The Prophet believed in what Allah revealed to him. وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ, and the believer, كُلٌ, all of them, كُلٌ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ, believe in God. وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ, and the angels, وَرُسُولِهِ, and the messengers. لَا نُفَرِّقُ بَيْنَ أَحَدٍ. We didn't separate, we didn't discriminate, we didn't, all of them are equal. لا نفرق بين أحد برسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير. And they said, we obey, we listen, we ask your forgiveness, our last destination to you, our Lord. So, كذب الثمود المرسلين, they denied all the messengers because they deny their messenger. And that means if you deny your messenger, you deny everyone. Someone said, no, I believe in this, but not believe in this. No, all of them from God, all of them from Allah. And we have to believe in all of them. إِذْ قَالَ لَهُمْ أَخُوهُمْ صَالِحٌ أَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. Again and again, their brother. I didn't repeat. Allah who repeated this. Their brother, you are as human, you should act with all humanity as brothers and sisters. This is a fact. I know a scholar in Damascus, my city, 40 years ago. He said, Christians are our brothers. The khutaba make him rejecter on their Jum'ah prayer. Yes, they told he is a rejecter because he said that we are brothers with the Christian. What is this? Allah said, they, Thamud, denied the messengers. They are disbeliever. They denied the messenger. They are disbeliever. They are rejecter. And in the second ayah, in ayah number 142, again and again, Allah said, إِذْ قَالَ لَهُمْ أَخُوهُمْ صَالِحٌ. Their brother صالح. صالح is a prophet. أَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. You don't fear Allah. You don't take care of this. You don't protect us from his hell. إني لكم رسول أمين. I am an honest messenger for you. I am an honest messenger. Honesty. Honesty is very important for the people who will work in the field of religion. Honesty from the business problem. Honesty from the moral problem. Honesty from the money problem. It's a big problem if we are working in religion because of money, because of politics, because of we need a position in the government. No, it is not. Religion shouldn't be the way of this. Religion should be the way to teach people how to become closer to Allah, how to increase your level of morality and spirituality. This is the reality. إني لكم رسول أمين. إني لكم رسول أمين. What is important for Rasulullah that he lead the ummah to be great ummah in Jannah. Yes, he make them great also in the earth. Because if you are great in the heaven, you will be great in the earth. Because the earth deserves nothing comparing with the world of heaven. For this reason, إني لكم رسول أمين. Honesty. Okay. And someone said, I don't want to be because I am not honest. No. Try to be honest and become honest and become honest day by day more and more and more. There is one, no one just born and he has full honesty. No. To be honest is something you have to gain it. Something you have to educate your nafs, your soul about it. إِنِّي لَكُمْ رَسُولٌ أَمِينٌ فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُونَ آية number 144 فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُونَ So fear Allah and obey him. Fear Allah and obey him. When you listen حَيَّ عَلَى الصَّلَاةِ حَيَّ عَلَى الْفَلَاحِ in the adhan, you have to say in your heart, Oh Allah, I am ready. Oh لبيك اللهم لبيك. When you recite any Surah in the Quran or any ayah in the Quran and Allah ask you to do, you have to say, oh Allah, I agree. Oh Allah, I am ready to what you want from me. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُونَ وَمَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ مِنْ أَجْرٍ إِنْ أَجْرِي إِلَّا عَلَى رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ I don't ask you anything in reward from this. أَتَتْرُكُونَ فِي مَا هَاهُنَا آمِنِينَ Ayah number 146. في جنات وعيون وزروع ونخل طلعها هضيم and now صالح described their situation. You live in very great life. You have everything. You live in gardens and springs and you have date and palms and you have a lot of vegetables and a lot of fruit and also وتنحتون من الجبال بيوتا فارهين ayah number 149 and you grave and shape from the mountain your palaces and your homes. You see their homes in the mountain. How much is it secure? Today in the modern life the houses is just wood and any hurricanes will take off the roof or take off the ceiling. And we see this every time in the YouTube and in the news here and there. And if there is a flood, it will take all the house with it. But how can the flood take the mountain? How can the hurricane take the mountain? They build their houses in the mountain. What does that mean? That means they were secure more than us, more than our houses, more. وَتَنْحِتُونَ مِنَ الْجِبَالِ بُيُوتًا فَارِهِينَ Yes, it is good. It is good if you fear Allah, if you obey Allah. For this reason, the Prophet advised them, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُونَ اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ take care, listen to Allah, obey Allah, listen to what Allah asks you. Where Allah asks us? In the Quran. Where Allah order us? In the Quran. Everything in this book, and we are responsible about every sentence in this book. We are responsible about every letters in this book, not any else book. Today, as I said before, there are more than 140 million books. 140 million books. If you just need to know the names of those books, you have to spend your life. We have to understand what is the first priority. And also in the Islamic knowledge, there are hundreds of thousands of books, plenty of books. If you will spend your life in this and this and this and this. No, it is not. You have to put your priorities. The life is short. Our age is short. And we have to focus about what is important to our life. So, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُونَ وَلَا تُطِيعُوا أَمْرَ الْمُسْرِفِينَ. And don't obey the order of transgressors, the oppressors, the people who don't care, the people who control and don't care about the matter of Allah, the people who care only about the materialism, about the money, about the dunya. They spend everything in this, and this occupied their mind, occupied their spirit, occupied their soul. So, وَلَا تُطِيعُوا أَمْرَى الْمُسْرِفِينَ. Who are those مُسْرِفِينَ? الَّذِينَ يُفْسِدُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا يُصْلِحُونَ. Who make mischief on the land and who not set things right. And if we will ask a question today, human today, listen to the honest people. Human today, listen to the righteous people, or they listen to the corrupted people, the people who spread mischief and corrupted everywhere. Today, human and those people spread corrupted everywhere in the ocean. They are going to the deepest point in the ocean and they found plastic bottle, empty blood. Corruption for everything, for morals, corruption for way of thinking, corruption in the media, in the art, in everything now. And this is very big problem. And now the man, the human, start to corrupt the design of Allah about humanity. And this is more and more and more big problem. الَّذِينَ يُفْسِدُونَ بِالْأَرْضِ وَلَا يُصْلِحُونَ. So after the Prophet told them this recommendation, after he advised them, after he clarified them the way they should go on it, what is the answer? قَالُوا إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مِنَ الْمُسَحَّرِينَ. They said, you are only of those affected by magic. You are one of those bewitched. Someone make magic to you and you affected by magic. You have to understand something. People can make magic to Prophet. But we have to understand that Prophet will not affected by magic. And if someone said that Prophet Muhammad, someone to, it's a false, it's a lying. Whatever who said, and wherever you read this, about the Prophet or any other Prophet, no one can affect the messenger by magic. Because Allah protected him from this. And someone said, oh, I read this here, or it's false. It's false. Because who said that? قالوا إنما أنت من المسحرين. The rejected people said that you are from the people who affected by magic. Normal person can affected by magic. Normal person. But the Prophet and Messenger? No way. No way. 100%. Not 99. 100%. Some people narrated some story about the Prophet Muhammad that he affected by magic. It's false 100%. This is what the rejecter said. And قالوا إنما أنت من المسحرين. You are one who affected by magic. And this is the saying of the rejecter. ما أنت إلا بشر مثلنا. فأتي بآية إن كنت من الصادقين. You are only now after the story of magic, there is another story. After the story of the magic, they said, okay, you are just a human like us. Of course, Allah sent to us humans. But unfortunately, we make this, we reject these humans or make them gods. This is the Satan. This is the Satan. The Satan make the human two group. To disbelieve in messengers, to deny the messengers, or to make them gods. Unfortunately. But to act with the messengers as a messenger from Allah, as one who teaching us the way of Allah, as one who lead us to become closer to Allah, this is very rare nowadays. Very rare. Subhanallah. For this reason, ما أنت إلا بشر مثلنا فأتي بآية. We need a sign. We need a sign for what? To believe? There are endless of signs around you. No, we need special sign. For what? To go more and more in your stray. To go more and more in your stubbornness. This is the problem. Okay. This is very good example in story of Salih alayhi salam, that those people ask for a sign. And Allah gave to them this sign. قال ما أنت إلا بشر مثلنا in ayah number 154. You are just human like us. So we need a sign to prove to us that you are truthful. Okay. The Prophet make a dua to them and they have a sign as they exactly asked about. They need female camel. They need so-and-so. And Allah responds to them and he told them, as you ask, this is the female camel and she will use the water for a day. You use it in the second day. And it's organized the way between them. And take care. Don't touch it. وَلَا تَمَسَّوْهَا بِسُوءٍ فَيَأْخُذُكُمْ عَذَابُ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. So don't touch her with evil. Lest you should be seized by a painful punishment. It's ayah number 156. The Prophet told them, this is the sign as you asked. But don't touch it. So, what did they do? What did they do? فعقروها. They killed it. They slaughtered it. Then they become very sorrow about this. Regretful. But after what? After they have the punishment. فعقروها. So, look to this word. This word is very important. It's in Arabic, فَعَقَرُوهَا, that means all of them. All of them, they killed the camel. But in reality, who killed the camel is one. How Allah here said to us, فَعَقَرُوهَا, all of them killed the camel. That means all of them are partner. The people who plan for this are nine. And meeting for this are nine. And the person who kill is one. And the people who agree, the people who like this, the people who didn't stop them, didn't hate them, all of them are partner in the crime. فَعَقَرُوهَا, all of them. For this reason, we have to watch ourselves. Don't be partner in any crime. Don't be partner in any sin. How could I be partner? Maybe you watch the YouTube and you love to eat. And you didn't say, okay, this is wrong. This is wrong. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam put the plan to us. If someone of you see anything wrong, he should fix it by force. And this is the rule of the government. This is the rule of the authority. They put the police to monitor the speed. And they stop you and they give you a ticket and they punish you. Okay, this is the matter of police. But if you watch someone with high speed, you do nothing. You cannot give him a ticket. You cannot punish him. You just keep going. But Rasulullah give us the plan. If you see something wrong, fix it by your hand, by your force. And this is for the authority. The authority in the family, the authority in the government, the authority in the city. If you couldn't, by your tongue, and this is the preacher, the people who has mana, the people who can, who has the media, they say what is right, what is wrong. And if you couldn't, in your heart. And this is our rule. When you saw something wrong, did you say in your heart, oh Allah, this is wrong and I cannot change it, but I didn't accept it? If you watch about something in the TV, about a crime, about something bad, something, someone acting in wrong way, do you deny this in your heart? Unfortunately, most of us didn't do this. We have to watch this because we are surrounded about wrong things. At least you have to deny this in your heart. But if someone you can't talk to him, you should talk to him. If someone you can help him, you should help him to change this. It's according to your situation. But at least you have to deny this in your heart. Allahumma inna hadha munkarun. Oh Allah, this is wrong. La aqdiru ala taghyirih. I couldn't change it. But I didn't accept it. La ardabi. La ardabi. I didn't accept it. So, fa'aqaruha. Otherwise, all of them are partners. All of them. All of them kill. All of them kill the camel. فأخذهم العذاب إن في ذلك لآية وما كان أكثرهم مؤمنين. So the punishment took all of them. Why the punishment took all of them? The killer is one. No, because all of them are partner in different way. فأخذهم العذاب إن في ذلك لآية. In this there is a sign. There is a sign. There is a sign to me. There is a sign to you, to her, to everyone. There is a sign. Don't be partner in any sin. You know what? Sometimes someone listens to story. It's a bad story about someone do something bad. Oh, and he said, oh, I wish be like him. Someone watched someone drinking wine. And he said, oh, I wish to do this. He didn't do it. But he take the sayyat. He take the sin as he do it. Because he agree, because he accept, because he satisfied, because he support, because he didn't deny in his heart. فَأَخَذَهُمُ الْعَذَابِ إِنَّ فِي ذَٰلِكَ لَآيَةٌ. There is a sign in it. وَمَا كَانَ أَكْثَرُهُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. But most of them are not believers. Most of them are not believers. So we have to be true believers. Otherwise, we will including in any punishment from the heaven. وَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الرَّحِيمُ. And indeed, your Lord is the mighty and the merciful. Your Lord is the mighty. Your Lord is the all power. Your Lord is al-aziz, the all honor. The Almighty, the all, anything, any idea, any acting from the human against this meaning is satanic movement, is satanic action. Allah is the Almighty. Allah is Al-Aziz. No one can harm him. No one can touch him. No one can did or do anything bad to him. And any idea opposite of the mighty of God, any idea opposite of this meaning and this understanding is a false, is a false. Who created all these heavens and created all these galaxies and created everything? We can't harm him. Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned in the Hadith Qudsi, Ya Ibadi, إنكم لم تبلغوا نفعي فتنفعون. You didn't reach the level to benefit me. وإنكم لا تملكون ضري فتضروني. And you cannot harm me. So you couldn't harm me. يا عبادي لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم If all of you, from the beginning to the ending, and from the jinn and from the human, اجتمعوا بصعيد واحد, come together in one field, and ask me whatever they want, and they ask me everything they can imagine, everything they can think about, everything they wish they want, ما نقص ذلك من ملكي إلا كما ينقص المخيط من ماء البحر. This will not decrease from what I own, except if you put a needle in the ocean and take it out. How much the ocean will decrease? This is the Almighty God. This is the Almighty God. Some people give us picture to God, to emulate the God, to put the God in very low level. How can we worship this God? How can we accept this God? Allah is the source of wisdom. Allah is the source of strength. Allah is the source of nur, the source of power. This is the highly understanding of Allah Azza wa Jal. And this is what Allah described in every position in the Quran. And anything against this, anything not going with this, is a false. And this is very important station on the straight way. وَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ, your Lord, لَهُوَ, all emphasizing, إِنَّ emphasizing, this letter in Arabic to emphasize, and wa, to swear, and رَبَّكَ with the ka is more emphasizing, لَهُوَ, all type of emphasizing in five words. Emphasize what? To make certainty about what? Allah is لَهُوَ العزيز, the mighty. So if you feel anything inside you, you have to fix your soul. If you feel any idea, if the Satan can access and whisper to your heart anything not good about Allah, you mean that you need to fix, you clean your heart, you purify your soul today before tomorrow, because you don't know when this life will end. May Allah give you khair and barakah. May Allah help of us to follow His teaching. Help us to obey what He asks us to do. Help us to understand the wisdom behind the sign, to understand the wisdom behind the story of the Prophet. We feel that as we are with the Prophet Salih. Give us the teachings to his people. Yes, and this is the revelation of the heaven. This is what Allah revealed to Prophet Muhammad. And from this revelation, he gave to the humanity the best nation they can ever imagine about. May Allah give you khair and afiyah. May Allah give you all his mercy. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Al-Fatiha. A'udhu Billahi Min Shaitan Ar-Rajim. Bismillah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم أعنا على دوام ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك, ولا تجعلنا يا إلهنا يا مولانا من الغافلين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه, وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون, وسلام على المرسلين, والحمد لله رب العالمين. إلى شرف النبي وأرواح المؤمنين. الفاتحة.